So girls, what's your plan for graduation? What are you going to do?
I don't know, we haven't really thought about it.
How about a video or something?
Oh yeah, that could be cool.
Yeah. But we've only got 3 days left. What are we going to do?
Take that picture from that frame. I'll put it in my pocket so that every day you're with me. I keep you close to my heart. Give me one more kiss before the boys arrive. Nashville to San Francisco is a hell of a drive. But don't worry, the Lord is good when the road is wrong. And we'll be back before you know.
Matilda Jarrett, first crush at Emmanuel.
It'd have to be Reese Batterham in grade 5.
Reese Batter!
Grace, who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
Oh, probably Jack. Yeah, it would have been Jack when I was like in year 2 or 3 or something.
Tara, you're up next.
I think mine would have been like Reese.
Who was your first crush? First crush at Emmanuel.
Tom Whittle.
James.
What?
First crush at Emmanuel, go.
Yeah, it was actually Sophie Orshan.
Joe, first crush at Emmanuel.
You.
All right, Tyler, first crush at Emmanuel.
First crush, probably Abby Bouchard.
First crush at Emmanuel. Right.
I had a crush on Nick Wong in grade 5.
Laird. First crush on Emmanuel.
Yeah, probably Belinda.
No, was it?
Belinda.
Georgia. You asked her out on a date.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Oh, Pulford. First crush on Emmanuel.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Look, I'm going to have to say Alec Little.
You say Maggie is sick.
No, like, genuinely, it actually was Maggie because I dated her in grade 7.
After she dated Josh?
Yeah.
That's a bit, like, you know, second best sort of thing. How do you feel now that you're dating her?
Good. That's so awkward, Sophie. Way to ruin the vibe.
Intermission. Oh. Hi, Charlie.
Hey, Izzy.
Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
That'd have to be Jack Darlin in grade... 8.
Wow.
Yeah.
Hey, Webb.
Hi.
Who's your first crush on Emmanuel?
Probably Nick.
Nick Wong.
Mm-hmm.
On the charts.
Right. Harry. First crush on Emmanuel, please.
I remember at year 7, you asked me out of the bus.
It was.
You dated me.
Yeah, I like you, mate.
How was it?
Oh my god.
What the? Jack, first crush to Emmanuel.
I reckon going back to prep in grade. Sorry, I'll be back.
One eternity later. Much, much, much later.
What was the question again?
Hey, Yosef.
Can I know your first crush at Emmanuel, please?
No.
My man, first crush at Emmanuel.
No.
Hey, yo, Jackson.
Who's your first crush at Emmanuel?
It'd have to be Miss Thompson.
Yeah, word. Why?
Because I don't want to.
Everyone else is, why aren't you?
Because I'm not going to.
Can I please know your first crush on Emmanuel?
Harry?
Harry? Oh, that's a bit sticky.
Is it because your dad's principal and you don't want to get in trouble?
Absolutely not.
First crushes, please, around the table, let's go.
Carlin.
Jaminky.
Carlin.
Mac.
Is it because your mum's his wife and you don't want to get in trouble? And she's my English teacher and your English teacher and you don't want to get in trouble?
First crushes.
Hey, guys! Can I ask you a question? First crushes at Emmanuel, go.
I don't remember anymore.
Who?
Manning Taylor.
I'm going to pretend like I know who that is.
Levi McNamara.
Levi?
Come on, Luca.
Oh, my God.
It is difficult to think about. That's...
Oh, my God. It was Jessica Sim?
Don't have one. That's fine.
How about you, Charlie?
No comment.
And just say your crush.
No.
It can be a grade 7 crush.
No.
Yep. Darius.
Yeah?
First crush on Emmanuel.
Oh, as soon as I stepped into the school, it was Lucy Brawl. Holy she was so, oh. But now I'm just like Siebs, you know, back then I was just so into it.
Who was your first crush on Emmanuel?
No, do I have to say it?
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Just, you can do this.
I don't want to. Miss Thompson.
First crush on Emmanuel. Josh Horton Prep.
Josh Horton.
Mac.
I feel like you might be lying, but that's fine.
Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
Is this going to be at the valedictory thing?
No!
Like publicly shamed?
No! Nah, you can trust me, mate. You can trust me.
Okay. I better not be seeing this at valedictory.
No, you won't.
Cure it.
So, who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
I think we all know the answer to that.
Just enlighten me.
I hate you all.
Who is it?
It was Ethan then.
Now showcasing the that were too scared to say their first high school crush.
Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
I never had one. Like, what do you mean? Like, grade 6?
No, like, your first crush ever at Emmanuel.
Why would I tell you that?
Just answer the question.
No!
Just answer the question. Connor, please.
What's your first crush at Emmanuel?
No comment.
That's all good.
I don't remember.
Sorry, babe.
Don't remember.
Freya. Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
I've never had one.
No, you have to have a crush. You have to have one crush at Emmanuel. We all know you've had one crush.
The other day and I couldn't come up with one.
Okay, like who's the most attractive boy to you in our grade then?
None.
Freya, give me something. Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
I don't know.
Just, what? You got to say a first crush.
Unless I don't want to do this.
Well, this is boring. Ow.
Alex.
Yes?
First crush at Emmanuel.
Is it all right if they're a bit older? Might be a potential teacher.
Right, who's this potential teacher?
Are they watching this?
Most likely, but
okay,
you know.
I'm not going to say.
Hey, Ethan.
Hey, how you going?
Not too bad. Who was your first crush at Emmanuel?
I didn't have a first crush, actually.
So, no one?
No.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
That was a park. Morning! Alright, so we are at the car park now. It's your average Thursday. Just getting a bag. Got my acai for brekkie. And we're about to walk up the long hill. Let's go. Oh, time to go. Oh, surely. Play some Hannah Montana. You know the one that's like,
song?
What?
I have it.
Day would come. We'd be standing one by one. Oh, it's you.
With the laughter, there be tears. Oh, we got Amy Thompson driving up the hill right now. She's got a personalised number plate, Tomo. Her husband, Jace, bought that for her. She was a bit embarrassed. Mac has a crush on Jace. We're not at the hard part yet, so this part's pretty flat. And then we get up to the top of the hill, like the bottom of the hill. It's just not a nice day after that, really. Like, you get quite sweaty. And sweat's not that much fun.
Oh,
he's hot. Oh, that one's also 60 hours. So we're starting to get to the harder part now. Starting to get a bit out of breath. Oh, this is so tiring. I need a hit. We've made it to the top. A little bit sweaty. Hairs in the face. Love it. So this is our school. Someone decided to knock down all the buildings, which is a bit dumb. We're going to the locker room now. We're going to put our bags away.
So here, this is our Emmanuel sporting facility. As sport captain, I pride myself on a fun, safe, educational sporting environment.
Stop! Family.
All right, this is our tutorial room. So we come in here on Monday afternoons. As you can see, the classroom is really quiet and everyone's working. Everyone's working really hard, as you can see.
Follow me this way into our drama class. We're in a different classroom at the moment because the music kids stole the theatre. But our class is very focused on creating cinematic pieces and we always work very hard. Moving on.
They love me.
So just follow me into the tuck shop. The tucky, if you will. Oh, Miss Haylock. Tell me, how do you like the tuck shop at this school?
Oh, tuck shop's great. I'm a big fan of tuck shop.
Me too.
Yeah, food, bought food, home food, it's all good.
She is my queen. Anyway,
welcome to the tuck shop.
How do you like the tuck shop at this school?
Oh.
How do you like the tuck shop at this school?
They do.
How do we all like the tuck shop?
So welcome to the hospitality room. I'm going to take you in. So we always are here on a Tuesday and a Friday afternoon and we work really, really hard and we really pride ourselves in our hygiene and how we work really safely because, you know, that's one of the things that we've learnt over the 2 years of working here. So everyone's just working really, really hard. There's no messing around. No eggs have been cracked. Nothing's been...
Food safety and hygiene. And the boys are... They're doing a... Boy, seriously, come on!
So here we are at the dance studio where no one actually... Like, no one comes here. But it's a haven, let's go. So Miss... she's about to not let us in the class. But we actually are in this class. We're getting in trouble right now. So here we are. We just got in trouble, Miss Archer.
So in trouble.
So this is the dance studio.
Wow.
All right, we're coming up to the pool. What's this? Sorry, sir. Repeat yourself.
You're on sector for being late, and that means you're going to have an after school next Thursday.
Ha. Jokes on you, I'm not here. Anyway,
Questions,
this is
This is the Emmanuel Pool. We like never come here, but it's here.
Is that actually on, that thing?
Yeah, it's actually on. Yeah. Testing. Yeah. It works. My question for you is, who were you most like in high school out of our cohort and why? Good one, hey?
Tough question. I actually think I told Jack Darlin's mum. Jack reminds me a little bit of myself in high school.
Jack Darlin, right.
Scary.
So quite rebellious?
I don't know if rebellious was the right word, but active, sporty, not really that interested in school.
In school?
Yeah.
Fair enough.
I guess I was in the end because I did okay. But so.
Well, he is graduating.
Probably a bit more effort than Jack. But.
Probably, yeah. And one more question while I'm here as well. You can choose either what are you going to miss most about our cohort or what are you going to miss least?
My take on your year level, fantastic people, no work ethic.
That's very true.
Yeah. I think if you ask most teachers that, they'll probably give you the same answer.
Yeah, fair enough. Thank you for your time, Mr. Sobey.
You're welcome.
Can I ask you a question, please? In high school, who are you most like? Yeah. When you're in high school, who are you most like in our grade 12 cohort?
In your cohort? Definitely not Tilly.
Oh.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello.
I would like to know who your favourite students are from our Year 12 cohort.
Well, it's very hard to pick favourite students from
such
a nice group. I am going to miss my Year 12 class because they have been a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. There have been a lot of characters. And this cohort was actually in my job interview here. And what I remember is Ewan being in my job interview. And he really tested me out while I was teaching the class in front of Mr. Shane and Mr. Kneidenberg and Mrs. Fillmore. And so, yeah, I'll never forget my job interview here because of Ewan.
I've located Nick Shane. Nick, I have a couple questions for you. I'd just like to know, who out of our lovely cohort were you most like in high school?
Most like out of you lot? Probably no one because I was a cool kid at school.
Oh.
But if I had to pick someone, I'd say Laird, except I was a lot taller and better looking.
I have one more question.
All right, Eva.
What are you going to miss least about our cohort?
Ooh, there's a couple of things. Perhaps the whinging, the not wearing uniform correctly, the antisocial behaviour in the bathroom.
Do you want to explain that a little bit?
No, I think everyone knows what I'm talking about.
Okay, fair enough.
Early departures, late arrivals, the list goes on.
Hey, sir.
Hi.
Can I ask you a quick couple of questions?
Sure.
I would like to know who you were most like in high school.
Probably Kira. She floats under the radar quite a bit, and I think I was quite quiet at school, but she's still high achieving.
She is, that's very true. And last question, what are you going to miss most about our cohort?
You guys are super friendly. When I first got here, you guys were lovely, and you taught me loads about Australia, and that connection is pretty amazing. I don't know if I'll have that again.
Well, I have a couple of questions. Who were you most like in high school out of our cohort?
Oh, that's a great question. I was a bit like Mac.
Why?
I was pretty sporty. Mm-hmm. I was a bit like Reese Batterham. I didn't like to tuck my shirt in. I was nothing like Joe because he's got musical talent and I don't.
I'm sorry, Mr. Blom, I have one more question.
Oh, sorry.
What are you going to miss the most about our grade?
Nothing.
They're going to be really upset about that. I feel like you have to say it just out of sympathy.
Let me think about it. Nothing.
Sneak attack on Miss Minky.
Good afternoon, Miss Minky.
Good afternoon, how are you?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm well, thanks.
Since you know our cohort so well, since your son, you know, is one of us, who would you say you are most like in our grade?
When I was in year 12, I think I was probably most like Emily.
Emily?
Yep.
Why is that?
Well, because she's quite smart and she's good at English, yep. But she's also a bit easily distracted and ditzy.
That was the word I was going for as well. Yeah.
Yeah, we're on the same page.
We are on the same page. So, very interesting. Miss Minky was Emily. Dick.
Who am I looking at you? Oh, Joe.
Hello, miss. What's the question again? Hello, miss. Who are you most like in the grade?
Hi, Joe. I think I was most like Kat because she's pretty quiet, chilled, relaxed. That was me at high school.
Interesting. And what will you miss most about our cohort?
I think with your cohort, well, particularly with the drama classes I've taught, the supportive nature of your group, and everyone just seems to get in there, have a good time, and there's just a, I don't know, just a really good vibe.
Hey, Queen.
Hi, girls.
Hi. Can we just ask you a couple questions?
Indeed, you can.
Who were you most like when you were in high school?
Interesting question. Okay, I was probably like Lucy Khan with a dose of Maggie Eva glint in the eye.
Ooh, very nice, very nice. Can you tell us your favourite outfit?
The striped top mullet skirt combo.
Miss, that is a 12 out of 10 outfit, let me tell you. What are you going to miss most or least about our cohort?
Goodness, I will definitely not miss the threats about jewellery. I'm not going to name names, but my goodness, I've been very tempted with some of the girls in our class. So much hardware, it's ridiculous.
You're going to miss most about our
cohort? What do I miss most? This sounds cheesy, but a really warm group of individuals, really lovely. You guys really banded together. It's been a beautiful year. I've had an absolute ball.
Thank you. And can you give us a quote to tell us, move us on to life?
Oh, look, for me, it's all about the green light, Maggie. It's all about the green light, reaching out to the green light, going after your dream. Let's hope yours are not unattainable.
Up in a blown out car, mothers, not everybody knows who we are. Stepped in the scene, all that 2 feet forward till we never get played like a game of cards. Round up, everybody you know. Pull up to the spot, let's go. It's time to run amok in the streets. If your name is curfew, then bitch, stay home. We're from a place where the boys get rowdy, girls love the party. Crack a few shots off the beat like Cardi. Burn a few rubbers, dose of the turbo. The riff is on fire, we lit like inferno. Ay, ay, the party's over here, turn all the way up 15. Watch the little flops disappear. The party don't stop, cause we're here. The party don't stop, so turn up the bass, let's all run amok. Turn up the bass, let's all run amok. Turn up the bass, turn up the bass, turn up the bass, turn up the bass, turn up, 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 turn up the bass, we're running amok, show up. Turn up the bass, we're running amok, show up. We're running a mock show.
Let the games begin. Let the games begin. Pass out. All my friends went and passed out. It's so much for the night. Last round for AM lovers. Well, that's how I come alive. I'm gonna be a people person in a room of people, people. I'ma keep on running this shit. Let the games begin. A people person in a room of people, people. I'ma be the kid for the win. Let the games begin.
Me not working hard, yeah right, picture that with a Kodak. Or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Took my life from negative to positive, I just want y'all to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life. Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's right.
Tonight, I will not love you tonight. Give me everything tonight. For all we know, we might not get tomorrow. Let's do it tonight.
It has been amazing getting to know you for the last 2 years. Since I got off the plane, you have been one of the best things about this school. I'm getting better and better because of you. You have made me better. So thank you very much for that. Have a little look at the letters that are in front of you. That is who you used to be. From today, you are the brand new version of yourself. Remember what you've been through so far. And look forward to all the things that are coming up. So, for the last time, say, yes, miss, good morning, sir, with enthusiasm and passion, like you mean it.
I'm sorry. Not starting until you're quiet. Abby, Jane, Sam, Josh. That's a bird.
I remember at the start of this year, actually doesn't seem that long ago that we met here day one for year 12, does it? And I said to you guys, hey, this is gonna go really quickly. And then all of a sudden, here we are on the last day. You guys have been a great group, and this moment here is a pretty special one. This is a moment where the whole college comes out and celebrates your journey with us. Everyone in the school is able to applaud and celebrate with you. Take the time to thank those who have supported you over the last 6 years.